गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माई क्लास। होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर कीपिंग फाइन। सो वी आर गोइंग टू डू लेसन 3 इफ आई वेयर अ किंग। द एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू डू बिकॉज आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड यू द लेसन। ओके, सो यू सी हियर, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू अंडरस्टैंडिंग द टेक्स्ट फर्स्ट। ओके, दिस इज टेक द करेक्ट आंसर्स। ऑलराइट, वी आर गोइंग टू डू दिस एक्सरसाइज। ए यू सी टेक द करेक्ट आंसर। आई एम गोइंग टू राइट ओनली द करेक्ट आंसर। Okay, so you see here, the boy would leave his gloves undone in Babylon or Timbuktu. So it will be Babylon. Okay, number one, you see here, the boy would leave his gloves undone in Babylon. Okay, so I am writing only the correct answer. Okay, here you see here. So in the form of blanks I am writing. Okay, the boy dash brushing his hair. Number two, you see, the boy liked or did not like brushing his hair. So the boy did not like brushing his hair. Okay, number three, you see, the boy would do lovely things in two options are given here, Greece or Timbuktu. So the answer will be Timbuktu, isn't it? Okay, next one, you see, a mantelpiece is found dash the house. A mantelpiece is found inside the house. Okay, and last one, the boy would be fun-loving or strict king. So the boy would be fun-loving king. The boy would be fun-loving king. Okay, okay. Once again I am saying you, please see the board. Okay, the boy would leave his gloves undone in Babylon or Timbuktu. So it will be Babylon. The boy would leave his gloves undone in Babylon. The boy liked or did not like brushing his hair. So the boy did not like brushing his hair. Okay. The boy would do lovely things in Greece or Timbuktu. The boy would do lovely things in Timbuktu. Okay. Number four, a mantelpiece is found inside the house or outside the house. So a mantelpiece is found inside the house. The boy would be a fun-loving or strict king. So the boy would be a fun-loving king. Okay, students. Now you see, exercise B and C, I would send you the question answers. All right. Okay. So now we are going to do playing with words. We will do. Please see, students. This one, playing with words, we are going to do. This is find two collocations for each of these words. Now, what is a collocation? A collocation is a combination of two or more words that often go together and sound just right. Now you see, any two words that go together, okay, together we use such words. They are known as collocations. Okay, like you see, you can say do the cooking, okay, do the shopping, then do your homework, do business, have a drink, have a good day, have a good time. We say all these words, isn't it? So you see, like first one is given here, come. Okay, you can say come close, you can say come early, You can say come first, come into view, isn't it? So here we are joining two words or two or more words we are joining, isn't it? So number one, see, number one you see it is given here, come, okay? So with come, how many words we can make? Only two words are said to make here. So you can say come early, come close, come early, okay, then come close, come early, come close, okay. Next one you see, make a difference, make a mistake, we say make. Make a difference. You can make a difference. We say no. You can make a difference. Then you see, you can write down make furniture, make room, make an effort. Okay. So make an effort. Make an effort to do your work. We say no. Please make an effort to do your work. So you see here, make an effort. Here three words we are joining, make an effort, make a difference. Here come early, two words, come close, two words are there, okay, with do. Number three with do, you see, do your homework, do business, do your homework. Okay, so do the cooking, do the shopping, you can say do the cooking, do the shopping, do business, do your homework, okay? With have, you see, with have you can make have a bath, have a drink, isn't it? Have a good time, have lunch, so you can write down have a bath. Please have a bath, we say. I'm going to have a bath, we say. Okay, have a bath, then have a drink, have a good time, have a good day. When you meet someone, you say, have a good day, have a good time. Okay, so now you have understood what is a collocation. A collocation is a combination of two or more words that often go together, okay, and sound just right. Okay, so when we join them, it sounds also okay. Now you please see, playing with words, this is A, okay, this is A. Come, with come you can make come early, come close, make a difference, make an effort. Three number do your homework, do business. With have a bath, have a good time, okay? Alright students, now we are going to do B number, okay? You see here, fill in the blanks with the correct words from the brackets. We have to choose two words, okay? Now you see, both the words, the pronunciation is almost same, but the spelling is different and the meaning is also different. Such words are known as homophones, okay? Some words sound the same but have different spellings and different meanings. They are called homophones, okay? So you see here, there are similar words, that is, the pronunciation is same, but the spelling is also different, the meaning is also different. So we are going to do exercise B. B number, you see, mother reminded me not to dash my new pen. Okay, we are doing exercise B. Fill in the blanks with the correct words from the brackets. Okay, this will be B. Okay, number one. So, mother reminded me. Not to dash my new pen. You should know the meanings of the words. First of all, what is the most important thing here? Mother reminded me not to lose. L-O-O-S-E, lose. And one is L-O-S-E, lose. Okay. So which one will be correct? L-O-S-E, lose will be correct. Mother reminded me not to lose my new pen. Here, lose means when you lose something, okay, the past tense of lose is lost. So when you lose something, L-O-S-E, lose, you are not getting something, you have lost it, isn't it? Okay, they are waiting for dash card. they are waiting. They are waiting for their car. They are waiting for their car. Okay, T-H-E-R-E, there is there, and T-H-E-I-R there. So it will be they are waiting for their car. T-H-E-I-R. One should never dash anyone. One should never dash anyone. So beat anyone. B-E-A-T, beat, and B-E-E-T, beat. So B-E-A-T, beat anyone. Okay, one should not. No, one should never beat anyone. Okay, number four, you see, you must have money to pay the bus fare. You must have money to pay the bus fare. The bus, it is, two spellings are given here, F-A-I-R, fare, and F-A-R-E, fare. So, when you pay, when you are traveling by bus, the conductor comes, you pay the fare, that is F-A-R-E, fare, bus, fare, okay? You give the money for the ticket, that is your fare, okay? Train fare, bus fare, okay. Which dress did you dash? Which dress did you choose? C-H-O-O-S-E means select. Which dress did you choose? Okay, C-H-E-W-S. Choose. That is also choose actually. The pronunciation will come. So, which dress did you choose? Please see once again. See the board. Okay. Mother reminded me not to lose my new pen. They are waiting for their car. One should never beat anyone. You must have money to pay the bus fare. Which dress did you choose? Okay. So now we are going to do synonyms. This is exercise C. Circle the synonyms of the words given in colors. Now what are synonyms? Synonyms are words with similar meanings. Okay. Or words which mean the same. Okay. So synonyms are words which means the same as the given word or with similar meaning. Okay, so we are going to do exercise C now. So now you see, this is exercise C we are doing. Okay, we are doing exercise C now. You see here, circle the synonyms of the words given in color. Okay, this is C, we are doing C. Okay, so circle the synonyms of the words given in color. You see here, cold is given, it is in red. So, we have to find out the synonyms for cold. Now, here four options are given. Okay, I am going to write only the correct option. Okay, so you see here cold is given. What are the words given for cold? Warm, chilly, pleasant, freezing. So, it will be chilly and freezing. For cold, number one, for cold it will be chilly and freezing. Chilly, freezing. Both means cold. Okay. Number two, you see. Wet. So, for wet, which words will go? Which are the synonyms for wet? These are the synonyms for cold. Chilly, freezing. Okay. For wet, dry, moist, clean, damp. Okay. So, you see here, moist and damp. Okay. Moist and damp will be synonyms for wet. Moist, damp. Alright, next one you see, huge is given. So which are the synonyms for, which words are the synonyms for huge? Tiny, gigantic, small or large? It will be gigantic and large. Okay, gigantic and large will be synonyms for huge. Number four you see, courageous. Courageous. Which words will be synonyms for courageous? Afraid, bold, brave, witty. So it will be bold and brave. Okay. Bold and brave. All right, next one you see, number 5, glad. For glad, which will be the synonyms? Pleased, disappointed, amazed, happy. So pleased and happy. Pleased and happy will be synonyms for glad. Okay, now you see here, what are synonyms? Please see, synonyms, as you know, are words which mean the same as the given word. So these words also mean the same as the given word. Here, which word is given? Please see here, the word cold is given. So synonyms for cold, they are chilly and freezing. Synonyms for wet, moist and damp. Okay, synonyms for huge, gigantic and large. Synonyms for courageous, bold and brave. Synonyms for glad, pleased and happy. So we have completed our playing with words. Okay, question answers I'll be sending you through Tenno. All right, question answers, answer the following questions and answer the questions with reference to the context I'll be sending you. So students, you are requested to copy down all these things in your English literature copies. Okay, thank you.